Eighth house is a very interesting house, you know. It is that house which tells you it is good to be bad. It is great to be bad, actually. Not good, it's great. It is so great to be bad that you end up in depression one day, but still you are happy that you are indulging it. And eighth house will show you. Eighth house is basically the graveyard, smashan. So the planet in the eighth house can give you a feeling as if you are in the graveyard because of that planet. So suppose Venus is in the eighth house. I feel as if I'm in the graveyard because of my wife. 10th Lord in the 8th. My career has become like a graveyard for me. 8th house is the 12th of the 9th house. It shows loss of dharma. So the 8th house is in a way the most dusthana house among all. Because it will tell you that why you should not go to spirituality. What is the reason what is that reason why you should stay away from God? Denial of God, 12th from the 9th. And it is the 2nd from the 7th house, which means it is the attachment which is caused. How do you feel when somebody you are attached to leaves you? You feel as if you are in a graveyard. Everything is over. So that's the graveyard is. So in essence, the 8th house is, it is having the power to give you doubts in spiritual life. That is why if a person has too many planets in the 8th house, the person will take to some spiritual practice, he will leave it. He will take leave. He will keep dancing like this. Because he's not convinced that if God exists or not. He sometimes thinks God exists. Sometimes he thinks, oh, maybe God doesn't exist. And when you are headless, then what you do? You get into addictions. Therefore, it is also the house of addictions. Eighth house gives you all forms of nefarious addictions. And eighth house will tell you that you don't need God. You don't need God. You are all by yourself. You are all powerful. Just enjoy till the end. Have you seen people? Just do it. They will have a tag name. Do whatever you want in life, wherever, how much ever. There is no law. There is no karma. There is nothing. All these are under the implications of the eighth house. So what happens is eventually they feel that life is like a graveyard. Eventually they will feel like this. They will not feel it in the beginning. They will feel it eventually. And the 6th house is the 11th house from the 8th house. Gain of sinful activities. So 6th house is all problems of life. So the more you commit sin, the more you get troubles in life. And the 4 primary sinful activities are listed in the Srimad Bhagavatam. The first one is eating meat. Then it's intoxication, any kind of wine or cigarette or whatever it is. Then it is gambling. And then it is illicit sex. Illicit sex means you have physical relation with somebody outside marriage. So Saturn is the Karaka for the 8th house, and he's the only Karaka for the 8th house. So 8th house is the core domain of Saturn. That is why he's the judge. He punishes everybody for the sins which they have done. And eighth house also shows your ability to get up in the morning. If a person has a difficulty in the eighth house, the person cannot get up early in the morning. And that is why he cannot chant mantras. These people are late sleepers and late risers. So Rahu becomes more and more and more and more prominent in their lives. And they get doomed even late. They sleep at 4 a.m. and you should get up during Brahma Muhurat. They will sleep at that time. They are watching TV serials or anything else they are doing. The whole life gets ruined because of the 8th house. 8th house, why 8th house is the most difficult house? Because it's the denial of dharma only. You will see if a person has too many planets or too many malefics there, you talk about spirituality with them. They will give you arguments like, what's your problem, man? It seems you don't have a girlfriend. That is why you are into God and all this stuff. Just get a girlfriend. Just get a better job. You'll be happy. You can enjoy endlessly in this world. There's no hindrance. Because they are totally convinced that materialistic life is all in all. And ultimately, that is why they suffer very badly. There is no house which can give you so much pain than the 8th house. And the reason is, the only reason is, because this material world, as Lord Krishna says in the Gita, is temporary. Which means, today you love somebody, tomorrow either that person may not love you, or you may not love that person, or that person may die, or you may die. One of the four will happen. It has to happen with everybody. You will not live for eternity here. So, you get that experience that yes, this person is not there anymore with me. She is not there. He is not there. Or what happens at the end, you get everything and then you are like, this is all life is about, you know, I mean, running after materialistic pleasures. That is why it is the house of affairs also, extramarital affairs. Who does extramarital affair? The person who is totally convinced, right, that physical pleasure will give me happiness. Totally convinced. And that is why this house gives you highest levels of suffering, because one day or the other, by some means, that thing is taken away from you. Because in material world, everything has a timeline. This will be there for 10 years, 20 years, 30 years, depending on the karma. So when that is taken away from them, they cannot handle it because they're so much attached. I'm attached to this, you know, I want this. That's what addiction is, right? You know it is wrong that you should stop doing this, but still you are helpless. You are. And the only mantra for the 8th house is the mantra for Saturn. That is Om Namo Narayanaya. This is the mantra. Om Namo Narayanaya. Anybody has any planet in the 8th house, even if it is Jupiter, Sun, Moon, or whoever that planet is. Doesn't matter, or even if you don't have any planet, you must chant this mantra. Because this is the mantra that will give you the faith that ultimately only Lord Narayan can give you happiness, nobody else. Then you stop running after materialistic pleasure day in and day out. Then there is no graveyard, you see. Because then you are not attached. So when you chant this mantra, you will get this. My guru used to say, be affectionate but not attached. Very difficult. And be detached but not hard-hearted. Our problem is we do the opposite. We don't get detached, we just become hard-hearted. And we are not affectionate, we are just attached. Like Dhritarashtra was attached to Duryodhan. Duryodhan said, oh, I will disrobe Draupadi in front of everybody. And Dhritarashtra is like, I can't say anything because I am attached. What if he feels bad, you know? It is okay to insult a woman in public, but my son should not feel bad. Even if she is the, she's my kul vadhu, you know. Kul vadhu means your, she's like your daughter-in-law. It's okay, you can insult her, there's no problem. But my son should not, he should not feel bad, you know. What a level of helplessness this is. He, this character from the Mahabharata signifies the entire 8th house. Helplessness. And 8th house is also the 12th from the 9th. It is the feet of your guru. 12th house is the feet, right? So anybody who has difficulties with 8th house, they need to personally render service to sadhus. Only then this can happen. Otherwise, the 8th, there is no remedy for 8th house. 8th house is like hands down. Because 8th house is the denial of God's blessings only. So when God has said, I will not bless you, then the sadhus and the great saints, they have to come and tell, we will tell God to bless you, don't worry. And then the 8th house will improve. And for the 8th house, you can always read the 5th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam. You can make a note. The pastime of Bharat Maharaj is there in that. Bharat Maharaj is the one after whom India is named, Bharata. He's not the brother of Lord Ram. He's not this Bharat. He's a different Bharat. And he's the son of Rishabdev, who is one of the avatars of Lord Vishnu. So he says, Tapo Divyam Putra Kayena Sattvam. That famous sloka is there. Mat Sevanam Api Dwara Vimukteshu. So when you render service to the great souls, who are realized in spiritual knowledge and who are practicing and preaching the word of God, then Mahat Sevanam Dwara Vimukteshu. Dwara Vimukteshu means the doors to mukti, liberation, will open like this. You don't have to open them, they will open up for you. So you can help them in any way. If you know somebody is spreading spiritual knowledge, you can help them in any way, whichever way it is possible. By any kind of help, monetary help, or you can physically help them. So that is the only remedy. And of course, this mantra is always there. Someone is saying, Atma Karaka and Amatya Karaka in the 8th house. Wow, fantastic. Alright, so any questions on the 8th house? Yes, Anil ji.
Sir, 8th house is the house of our Pitra. And the curse of our Pitra. If we do the seva in the name of our Pitra, that can be remedy or not?
See, when you talk of Pitris and all this, now you have to understand, although that's a very great thing which is recommended in the scriptures, but that is not necessarily connecting us to God. Not necessarily.
You know, this is curse of Pitra. This is one of the curse of the Pitra in the 8th house.
Okay, I don't know regarding this. But yeah, if there is something to the related to the Pitris, that you can always do. Because Pitris are the 9th.
Charity in the name of them and the donations in the name of them. Right.
Donations and charity is more of the 12th house thing, you know. But you can also do it if there is some issue in the 8th house. So there is... And that is why I have not spoken on anything. Saturn in 8th, what it does. Like I spoke for 6th house. There's no need of 8th house. 8th house is pure 8th house.
Tyag. It's a second level of the Tyag train. Moksha.
Yeah. And unless you get rid of the 8th house, you will not get moksha.
If you are Lagna in 8th house, that means you have to Tyag yourself for the growth of other people. Only then you will pay the debt.
Fantastic. So eighth house is very important. 8th house is very important.
8th house is the second from the 7th. That means growth of other people. Unless otherwise you don't tyag yourself, you can't do the growth of other people.
There you go.
Right. Thank you.
Babaji.
Yes?
I have a question. Yes. Yes, so this mantra, Om Namo Narayanaya, Can this also be chanted? If, like, for example, there is a malefic in... I had this question when we were discussing sixth house. If Saturn is in sixth house, will this be a spiritual remedy for the sixth house as well?
Yeah, this mantra, anybody should chant, either you have a planet or not. Anybody, everybody should chant, because everybody has all these issues, right? Anybody who says that, if somebody says, I have no attachments to anything in this world, well, then you don't need to chant.
this will be a good mantra for sixth house as well, isn't it? For Saturn in sixth.
Yes. It will help you there also, but it will specifically help you here, because see, eighth house, the reason of the problem with the eighth house is it is the house where moon gets debilitated, and it also has Maran Karak in the eighth house, Scorpio in eighth house. So moon is your mind. Your mind is always fearful. What creates weaknesses? Fears, right?
Yeah.
You are fearful that maybe that person will leave me. So you are playing games. So many couples I know, they are playing games. And they are staying also. Or they think they are staying.
Also a house for in-laws?
Yeah, all those things you can keep doing. Second from seventh and all this. Okay?
Yeah.
You can keep doing that. Sixth, from sixth to this third. And that you can always do. In-laws and all this. But primarily it is the house of attachment. One word for the eighth house, attachment. And the entire Bhagavad Gita is on that only. Entire Gita, I'm saying. Because Arjuna says, oh, I am attached to Bhishma and Drona. I cannot kill them, you know. They are my loving teachers and my father, my grandfather, great-grandfather. How can I kill them? You know, it's horrendous to kill them. And then Krishna is telling, no. But they are siding on the side of Adharma. They have to be wiped out from this place. And that's what Krishna does, you know. It's very interesting. If you read the Gita, Arjuna says to Krishna, oh Krishna, please take my chariot in front of the army of the Kurus. I want to see who is there. Then Krishna does something very interesting. Krishna knows the weakness of Arjuna. Okay? He knows that Arjuna is extremely attached to Bhishma and Drona. Because he is God. He knows what is there in your heart. So what Krishna does is, he takes Arjuna's chariot exactly in front of Drona and Bhishma. He could have taken his chariot in front of Duryodhan and Dushasan, who had insulted Draupadi. Then Arjuna's blood would boil. Oh, these two rascals, they had insulted Draupadi. I will kill them. I will finish the battle today itself. But Krishna did not do. Krishna said, oh, wait, you have this weakness. I will bring it out. So he took it in front of Drona and Bhishma. And then Arjuna says, Kalpanya Doshopat. His hand is shivering. I cannot fight. He's saying, my Gandiva is slipping down from my hand. He's so attached. Of course, he was a great soul. That is why he was attached. But that's still an attachment. Now, it's great to be attached to them. But when they are siding on the side of irreligion, you cannot be attached to them. You have to wipe them out. And that's what Arjuna had to do eventually. So reading the Bhagavad Gita is also important. I mean, fifth canto is important. And fifth canto is doubly important for two reasons, you know. Because of Bharat Maharaj, and there's another reason. Anybody knows why? Because in fifth canto, there is a description of hellish planets. There are 28 special hells which are mentioned. Anyways, that's like a topic for some other day, but we can read those, you know, to get some fascinations. All right, and now we will go to the